concentrated flow erosion, grassed waterways, and the environment. Agriculture contributes 80% of the excessive phosphorus, P, flowing to the Gulf of Mexico from the Mississippi River Basin. Among the states contributing to this environmental impact, Kentucky is the sixth largest contributor of nitrogen and phosphorus to the Mississippi River Basin. Sediment is the leading cause of impairment of Kentucky's rivers and streams, impacting over 4,329 linear km, with agriculture being the primary contributing source. The problem of sedimentation, often underestimated, is enormous. It not only adversely impacts aquatic life and impairs ecological and economic functioning of drainage systems, wetlands, streams, and rivers, but also increases the risk of flooding and the need for water treatment. Properly constructed grassed waterways, NRCS Code 412, with appropriately sized vegetative filters on either side, reduce considerable runoff, nutrient, and sediment delivery to surface waters. Specifically, they reduce ephemeral gully erosion, which is a substantial but often overlooked problem that accounts for about 40% of all erosion in agricultural fields. In one study, the installation of grassed waterways led to reductions of 39 and 82% in runoff and sediment, respectively. In another study, grassed waterways reduced dissolved reactive phosphorus losses by factors ranging between 4 to 7 and particulate phosphorus by factors ranging between 4 and 10. Because grassed waterways are so effective, the USDA Conservation Reserve Program, CRP, and Environmental Quality Incentives Program, EQIP, provide funding for this and other conservation practices. Research objective. The objective of this study was to compare how predictions of concentrated flow erosion performed with LiDAR, survey grade RTK GPS, and 10-meter USGS DEMs, and using the D8, FD8, Demon, and D-flow direction models. Materials and methods. This study was conducted in five fields in Shelby County, located in the Outer Bluegrass Physiographic Region of Kentucky. Field A, 38 degrees 17 N, 85 degrees 9 W, B, 38 degrees 18 N, 85 degrees 11 W, C, 38 degrees 20 N, 85 degrees 12 W, D, 38 degrees 20 N, 85 degrees 11 W, and Field D, 38 degrees 20 N, 85 degrees 14 W, were 23, 36, 11, 57, and 33 hectares in size, respectively. The fields had been in a no-till, corn, Zea maize L, wheat, Triticum aestivum L, and double crop soybean or corn-wheat rotation for more than 20 years. Soils in this region developed primarily from limestone residuum overlain with podi sediment from limestone weathered materials and loess. One of the co-owners of the Worth and D. Ellis Farms was trained by the NRCS to identify eroded zones from concentrated water flow. The farmer delineated and mapped the eroded ephemeral gullies in the five study fields using a DGPS system. Subsequently, the farmer installed grassed waterways in these areas but did not reshape them, as is typically the case when installing these conservation structures. This is an important distinction because reshaping these locations would have changed the terrain attributes, making the analyses presented in this lecture difficult or impossible to interpret. Because these field observations were conducted by the farmer, we asked the NRCS district conservationist to validate the erosion delineations in the field. The conservationist visited the fields in 2008 and examined 42% of the eroded channels delineated by the farmer in the five study fields. He determined that all the channels would have been eligible for cost support for grassed waterways through the continuous USDA Conservation Reserve Program CRP program if they did not already have waterways installed. Survey-grade RTK GPS equipment was used to collect elevation data from Field D in 2000, Fields E and B in 2004, and in Fields A and C in 2007. Dual-frequency Trimble AD GPS 214, base station, and Trimble 5800, Rover, RDK receivers were used to create surveys in Fields A, B, C, and E. The survey for Field D was created with two single-frequency Trimble 4600 receivers, and elevation was determined during post-processing. The surveys were created at varying intensities with elevation measurements spaced approximately every 3, Field D, and 4 meters, Fields A, B, C, and E, along the direction of travel during the survey. There were 7.5, Field D, and 12 meters, fields A, B, C, and E, between survey passes. According to the Trimble data specifications, vertical errors for all receivers were expected to be